Don't ask me why. Don't ask me why.
In the next hour, we talk about whether there are rows in your home over who does the housework, and also the extraordinary story of the woman who made £500,000 by stealing things from shops and then bringing them back to get a refund. Have you had to give a suspicious refund? Radio 2 Smart Speaker Sounds App at 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 1 o'clock. This is Anthony Birchley. TikTok is banned from government phones. Leading economists calculate some of the effects of yesterday's budgets on households. And how two Liverpool fans' big bar bill landed them behind bars. TikTok has been banned from government phones and other devices used by ministers and civil servants with immediate effect. The decision has been taken on security grounds after the Chinese-owned video sharing app was accused of passing information about users to the Chinese government, something the firm denies. The announcement was made in the Commons in the past half hour by the Cabinet Office Minister, Oliver Dowden.
It is clear that there could be a risk around how sensitive government data is accessed and used by certain platforms. As many colleagues will know, social media apps collect and store huge amounts of user data, including contacts, user content, and geolocation data. On government devices, that data can be sensitive.
The economic think tank, the Institute for Fiscal Studies, has questioned the impact of one of the flagship policies in yesterday's budget. The Chancellor, Jeremy Hunt, announced the free childcare scheme for preschoolers would be extended to younger children between 9 months and 2 years old, allowing more parents to go back to work. But the IFS said the main effect of the policy would be to reduce the cost of childcare for those who've paid for it anyway. The IFS has also concluded that freezing income tax rates while earnings and inflation are rising will leave people less well off. Its director is Paul Johnson.
You won't see any difference in the amount you pay per pound, but because more of your money is being dragged into tax, then you'll be paying more tax altogether. So if you're earning between about £12,500 and £50,000 a year, you'll be £500 a year worse off. For a higher rate tax, we're earning more than £50,000 a year, you're £1,000 a year worse off.
There's been widespread disruption to rail services across England, Wales and Scotland as members of the RMT union hold another day of strikes over paying conditions. And school teachers in the National Education Union are staging a second successive walkout. But there are reports that ministers and unions representing hundreds of thousands of health workers, though not doctors, are close to reaching a deal. Our health correspondent Zoe Conway has more details.
What I understand is on the table at the moment is that there's going to be a significant one-off payment for this financial year. We're looking at well over £1,000, considerably more than that for people on some in some pay bands within the NHS. And for the next financial year, which starts next month, so 23-24, we're looking at something between, I'm told, 3.5-5% as a pay rise.
Gonorrhea cases in England have surged since COVID rules were relaxed. Health officials say people who have unprotected sex should get regularly tested. Our health reporter Michelle Roberts has the details.
The provisional data from the UK's Health Security Agency show gonorrhea diagnoses in the first half of 2022 exceeded 56,000. That's 21% higher than for the same period in 2019. The end of social distancing restrictions and more people being checked at sexual health clinics partly explain the rise. People can have no symptoms, which is why testing is so important. Experts say people should practice safe sex using condoms and get tested regularly.
John Lewis staff are to miss out on a bonus for only the second time after the firm reported a big slump in pre-tax profits. In the year to the end of January, it made a loss of £234 million. The high street chain, which also owns Waitrose, said it had more customers through the door, but they were spending less. Two Liverpool fans have been arrested in Madrid after ordering champagne for almost 100 people, then refusing to pay the bill. The incident took place at a nightclub in the early hours of yesterday morning before the team's game against Real Madrid in the Champions League last night. Our reporter in Madrid, Guy Hedgeco, has the story.
The two fans, both male, were in a nightclub in central Madrid when they started buying drinks for other clients. According to reports, they shouted, "We're millionaires," and they did pay a large bill early in the evening. However, after ordering a further 90 glasses of champagne for their fellow drinkers, they ran up another bill totaling €2,200, or £1,900. After trying to leave without paying, the duo got into a scuffle with staff and the police were called, arresting them on suspicion of fraud.
And a quick look at this afternoon's weather, and it'll be largely cloudy with some outbreaks of rain, which should gradually ease. Temperatures this afternoon reaching 10 Celsius in Cardiff, 11 in Glasgow, 12 in London, 13 Celsius in Belfast. That's the latest BBC News at 1:05.
Thank you. No, I shouldn't laugh about the football fans. No, I mustn't. Okay, in this hour, we will talk about the rows over the housework in your home. And the amazing refund story. How did somebody make £500,000 by lifting stuff from shops, then coming back with it a week later and saying, "I need a refund." She wouldn't have even had a receipt.